Selma Teacher 7, Mr. Barry here. Today I want to look into using older smartphones and turning them into a home security system. So let's get started with the lesson. Now I'd like to add at this time that no one is paying me to create this video. I feel that it's a really great way to turn your old cell phones into a great home security network for free. So let me go over the requirements first. Any Android phones that have Android OS 2.3 and up, basically this is most smartphones made after 2010. Be able to connect to your home Wi-Fi and have at least one working camera. For Apple phones, have iOS 8 or newer, be able to connect to your home Wi-Fi and have at least one good working camera. And now for the good stuff. Which app will we be using? We'll be using the Alfred Home Security camera, as seen here. Now let me show you how to install that. Okay, what you want to do is find the Play Store and then go ahead and click it, and that bring up the Play Store. Then you want to do a search for ALF or Alfred, and as soon as you type in ALF, you'll see it. Go ahead and click on Alfred Security Camera. It'll come up. Now just click on Install and then Accept. And then it'll be downloading. After it downloads, it'll then need to be installed, as it does here automatically. After it finishes installing, go ahead and click on the green open button. And it'll open up into this window here. It'll give you some suggestions on how to mount your camera, but I'll give you some too. Make sure you do log into your same Google account on any of your devices. And it does have really good motion detection too that you can change the sensitivity on. Now on this screen here, go ahead and click on the Start button and then choose to set up this device as either the viewer or the camera. Now you'll need to log into your Google account and make sure that it's the same Google account on the PC as well as the cell phone. So step one is to point this camera at where you want to monitor. Step number two, install Alfred on another device such as a Chromebook, another cell phone, or even a Windows PC. Select it as the viewer and then log into the same Gmail account. Then view it on your computer or your cell phone. Now, to do that, simply go to the website listed there. And then on the cell phone that's being the camera, you want to go ahead and click on to save power, and it turns off the LED screen and allows you to use your camera as a security phone with motion detection. So let's try this out. I typed in alfred.camera and let's see if the cameras load. Hey, there they are. And if I want to look at one of these here, you can then click it. It'll show you the live image there. So I raise my hand, there it is. So that's working. I go to this one. And if I raise my hand on this one, you can see it. Let's click on this one here, and yep, that works. Now let me show you what some of these icons mean. If you've been using it for a while, it'll record motion detection and that type of thing. And so any of the events will be recorded and left here for you. So then you can click it here, and let's just see this event. There you go, this is one of my night classes, and it does see very well at nighttime. So as you can see there, it records audio, and it can see in low light, not in total darkness, but as long as you have some type of light in the room, it'll pick it up very well, as seen here. So let me show you a demonstration with the lights out. And then I click on the moon here, so there we go. So as we can see here, the camera named Sky number 4 is using the low level filter. So let's click there. So let me show you these other icons down here. The first one is a snapshot. If you click it, it takes a snapshot and saves the image down on your hard drive. This will do a video recording. And remember, it will automatically do the video recording for you whenever it detects motion. And that might be anywhere between a 5 second or even a 35 second video that you can then view later. You can rotate the image. And then if your smartphone has a flashlight, you can turn it on. So let me go turn off the low light filter, turn off the flashlight. There we go, it goes back to dark, and you can turn on the low light filter. By the way, the low light filter on my other phones that I've been working with already for the last few nights works great, just like you see here. You can switch the camera too, because most smartphones have a forward facing and a rear facing camera. So if we click that, now it's facing the other way, so you can actually put one of the smartphones in the middle of the room and look at a 360 wide view of your room. This is full screen or not, and you can zoom in or zoom out, and then you can also exit to view your other smartphone's point of view. This very first icon here, if I click it, it shows you how many times was your camera disconnected. So if you're having issues with your network, or if your camera turns off for any reason, it will show here of when it was off. And this is why they recommend that your smartphone always be plugged into power, so it never runs out of power while it's working as a security camera. And this icon is anytime it records motion detection, as you saw earlier. Now, if you're viewing these on another cell phone, you also have an icon that looks like a microphone at the bottom of the screen. You click that, speak into it, and then your voice will be broadcasted to wherever the security camera is. So that's a nice feature. Now, the two ways that I've been using to mount my smartphones is one, by using a simple plate holder. Like you see here, phone sits in there, stays up. Another way is to use a cup, but you must remember to put a sock in it. That way the phone will sit up properly and not sink down too far into the cup. Well, now you know how to turn a smartphone into a security camera. Please give this video a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel, and leave a comment down below, as well as share the video. Thank you very much, and bye-bye.